India is a land of rivers. Blessed with a vast geographical extent, there are a number of rivers which carry historical, cultural, and economic significance. However, there are only a few prominent west-flowing rivers, amongst which River Tapi will be discussed comprehensively in this video. So without wasting your time, let's start. River Tapi flows in three states, which will be Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, and the state of Gujarat. So let's combine all the three states together and let us start our analysis immediately. So as we can see that there are multiple districts which we need to cover in our analysis. The River Tapi originates in the state of Madhya Pradesh from the district of Betul. From there it travels to the state of Maharashtra in the district of Amravati, forming the borders between the Khandwa district, Amravati district and the Betul district. It again enters into the district of Burhanpur, from where it travels in the southwesterly direction and enters the district of Jalgaon. As the River Tapi moves ahead, we also need to discuss some interesting and some really fabulous content. So this region has the famous mountain ranges which are known as the Gavilgad range. Here in the Gavilgad range also lies the Melghat Tiger Reserve. The Melghat Tiger Reserve is also famously known for being one of the projects amongst the first Tiger Reserve of 1973 Project Tiger. Thereafter, as the River Tapi traveled to the district of Burhanpur, we also need to know that here lies the most famous Asirgarh Fort. And why this Asirgarh Fort is most famous? This is because it was earlier used to be known as the Fort of the Deccan or the Key to the Deccan. Like in earlier times on the Mughal period, this entire region used to be known as the boundary of the Deccan. The above region used to be the Mughal Empire and the below region used to be the Deccan Empire. So this Asirgarh fort was impregnable and it was very difficult to capture this fort. That person who could capture this fort used to rule over the Deccan. So let's go ahead and as the River Tapi has now entered into the state of Maharashtra, we will be going ahead and from the district of Jalgaon, the River Tapi will be flowing and entering the district of Dhule. Thereafter, it will enter the state of Gujarat. It will enter the state of Gujarat through the Tapi district and flowing into the districts of Surat, it will ultimately discharge or dispose of in the Gulf of Cambay. Here we need to see some very important things which I think my video will add value if you will watch it till now and till the end. Like, one of the most important tributaries of the River Tapi is the River Purna. The River Purna originates in the Amravati district and flows from the Kola district, the Buldhana district, and ultimately joins the River Tapi in the Jalgaon district. Another major tributary which finds mention in this video is the Girna River, which flows from the Nasik district, and in the Jalgaon district it joins the River Tapi. Now a question comes, why is this Girna River really important? The Girna River is really important because it has the Chanakpur Dam, and the Chanakpur Dam was built by the British and it is the one of the largest dams in Maharashtra even till date today. In the Dhule district, there is also another river known as the Panchara River. This Panchara River acts as a tourist spot and attracts various tourists from the country to this place. Now, as we have seen that the River Tapi was entering into the state of Gujarat through the district of Tapi. What happened in the past that in the monsoon season, the River Tapi used to overflow and it brought a massive havoc in the entire districts. So here in the town of Ukai, it was built a famous Ukai Reservoir or the Ukai Dam, which used to block the river water, and the corresponding lake which has been generated here is also known as the Vallabh Sagar. So as we have seen the most famous tributaries and the important areas flows of the Tapi River, we must also discuss about the nearby mountainous regions which also are very important for us to know. So in the Nasik area, here lies the Satmala range, and just right side to the Nasik or to the east side near the Aurangabad district, there lies the Ajanta range. So guys, in this video we comprehensively discussed about the Tapi river. We discussed about its origin, its flows, the district it covers, and ultimately it enters into the state of Gujarat through the district Tapi and the districts of Surat. While in our next videos we will be discussing about the river Godavari and its, along with its multiple tributaries and the economic benefits that it has. So thank you so much for watching this video, and see you in the next video very soon.